हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम नरसिम्हलु, कॉमर्स टीचर वर्किंग इन तेलंगाना स्टेट मॉडल स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज टांडूर विकाराबाद डिस्ट्रिक्ट। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू सीईसी सेकंड ईयर अकाउंटेंसी यूनिट 4 Chapter 2 Partnership Accounts Admission of a Partner Part 5 Valuation of Goodwill under Different Methods. In last 4 videos I have explained 3 important adjustments which we make at the time of admission of a partner into the partnership firm. So this is the 4th adjustment, that is valuation of goodwill when a partner enters into the partnership firm. So in this video I will cover some points of valuation of goodwill, or one method I will cover in this video, and 2 more methods I will explain in the next video. So in this video what we are going to learn? Objectives, meaning and definition, features of goodwill, circumstances under which valuation of goodwill takes place, method of valuation of goodwill. So there are 3 methods: average profit method, super profit method, capitalization method. There are so many methods to valuation of goodwill, but for intermediate students in this chapter you have to learn only 3 methods. One is average profit method, second super profits method, third capitalization method. These three methods are important for you. So in this video I will teach one method, that is the average profits method. Remaining 2 methods I will explain in the next video. Now last problems and solution. Meaning and definition of goodwill. What does it mean? Goodwill means what? Goodwill means the reputation of business enterprise which acquires by its record of successful operations and customers' satisfaction. Goodwill is inseparable from the business. Goodwill is an intangible asset of the business. The value of goodwill is influenced by multiple factors such as future earnings, quality of its product or service, efficient human resource management, brand image, etc. So students, goodwill means nothing but the name and fame of the organization, or a reputation of a partnership firm. So how the partnership firm will get the name or a reputation? Very simple. By providing क्वालिटी प्रोडक्ट्स विद चीपर प्राइस और लो प्राइस एट लो प्राइस एंड दे ऑलवेज ट्राई टू सेटिस्फाई देयर कस्टमर्स प्रोवाइडिंग गुड सर्विसेस. सो हियर बाय दिस द पार्टनरशिप फर्म कैन गेट नेम एंड अ रिप्यूटेशन इन द मार्केट. सो दिस नेम एंड रिप्यूटेशन विल रिमेन अंटिल द फर्म इज क्लोज्ड. सो वी कांट सेपरेट द गुडविल फ्रॉम इट्स बिजनेस. So, for gaining a reputation in the market, we have to do so many activities, or we can say our goodwill, our firm goodwill will be influenced by so many things like quality products, efficient human resource management, a brand image, or future earnings. All these factors may influence the goodwill of the partnership firm. So, goodwill is an intangible asset, which means we can't see or touch it except feel or imagine, so that we can call it as intangible asset. Or in other words, we can say goodwill doesn't have any physical form or physical existence. So this is the goodwill definition. So we can go to see the definition. Goodwill is an intangible asset. It is the force of attracting the customers. It helps to earn more profits than normal profits in the future. This is the definition. Goodwill is an intangible asset. I already explained, I already told. Goodwill is an intangible asset which does not have any physical form. It is the force of attracting the customers. How we can go to understand this point? See, if you were asked to choose a pen when you are given two brands of pens, there are some X brand pen and Reynolds pen. So most probably you will choose a Reynolds pen because it has the brand. Reynolds company has a brand that attracts you to choose. So here the brand, the goodwill always works as a force at attracting the customers. How we can say the goodwill always attracting customers towards the business? It helps to earn more profits than normal profits in the future. So when we have goodwill, we definitely make more profits than normal profits in the future. For example, if there are two companies, one is X company, another is Reliance company. So here people trust already successfully working a business organization. People or customers do not simply believe a unknown company. So here we can say they're ready to invest their money in the company which has the goodwill in the society, or the partnership which has the goodwill in the society. Either you can go to take partnership or company or any form of organization. So they will get, or the firms, the business organization will get goodwill by performing some activities. So here, based on that, their level of profits going up than normal profits. Okay, so here the same companies, they are giving same types of products to the customer. They are supplying the same types of products to the customers, but one company makes more profit than the other company. So other company makes profits, that is normal profits, but this branded company, or we can say the company which has goodwill, can make more profits than normal profits. So simply we can go to understand, goodwill is an intangible asset. It is the force of attracting the customers. It helps to earn more profits than normal profits in the future. Children, I think you understood the meaning of goodwill and the definition of goodwill. Next, features of goodwill and circumstances under which it will be valuated. So what are the features of goodwill? We can go to observe. Already known points will come here, just you observe. Features of goodwill. It is an intangible asset. I already explained about this point. It is inseparable from the business. We can't separate the goodwill, and we cannot sell to outsiders the goodwill. If we want to sell the goodwill, we have to sell along with the firm. So we can't separate the goodwill from the business. It helps to earn more profits than normal profits in the future. So if our business organization has a goodwill, normally it makes abnormal profits than normal profits. So we can make more and more profits than normal profits if we have goodwill in the market. The value depend on various factors. The goodwill value depend on various factors. So what are the factors? We can go to observe. Future profits, customer satisfaction, quality of product and services, and managerial skills. Here, if we provide quality products, we can get good name in the market, and we will gain goodwill in the market. and a managerial skill. We can say a managerial skills means here we have to give good services to customers and brand image. So once we create the brand, that brand itself gives goodwill to the business organization, and based on that we can go to get lots of profits. A brand image, we can create the goodwill, creates the brand image. Okay, so these are the features of goodwill. What are the features of goodwill? Yes, it is an intangible asset. It is inseparable from the business. It helps to earn more profits than normal profits in the future. The value depend on the various factors. Those are future profits, customer satisfaction, quality of product and services, managerial skills, brand image. These are the features of goodwill. So your features of goodwill means characteristics of goodwill. Okay, right. Come to next one. Circumstances under which goodwill will be value. Where we can calculate or evaluate the goodwill. So situations. The situations where we can evaluate the goodwill. So that is called circumstances under which goodwill will be evaluated. So see, the first one, when the profit sharing ratio is changed. So normally the profit sharing ratio will be changed when a new partner enters into the partnership firm, or the existing partner retires from the partnership firm, or an existing partner get insolved, or the existing partner dies. So when the existing partner dies, the profit sharing ratio will be changed. So these are the situations for changing the profit sharing ratio. When the profit sharing ratio is changed, we need to calculate or evaluate the goodwill of the firm. When a new partner is admitted, generally whenever the new partner entering into the partnership firm, we need to calculate new profit sharing ratio. That is one point. And second, we need to evaluate the goodwill of the firm. When a partner retires or dies, so in such situations, if a partner takes retirement from the business, then we need to evaluate goodwill. If suppose one of the partner unexpectedly dies, then we need to evaluate the goodwill of the firm. When two firms are amalgamated or merged. So when two firms are amalgamated means nothing but joined together. So when two firms are joined together, then that is called amalgamation of firms. So at the time we have to evaluate the goodwill of the firm. When a firm is dissolved and sold to a company. So sometimes we may shut down the partnership firm for sale to a company. Means here we want to sell our partnership firm to a company. So then first we can go to dissolve our partnership firm and we can go to sell it to a company. So at the time of dissolve, we can go to evaluate the goodwill of the firm. So these are the situations where we can go to evaluate the goodwill of the firm, right? Methods of valuation of goodwill. It is the first method. There are total three methods. One is average profit method, next super profit method, third capitalization method. So first one, average profit method. Under average profit method, how we are going to evaluate goodwill of the firm? You can go to observe. Average profits method. Under this method, average profit of the last few years is ascertained, and thereafter the average profit is multiplied by an agreed number of years purchased. Here two important points we have to note. So what are the two important points? So first we can go to calculate the average profits of some number of years of profits. In the problem, you will be given for some or few years profits. For that few years profit, we can go to find average profits. Then we can go to multiply this average profit by the number of years purchased. Two important points. First, we can go to calculate the average profit. How we are going to get the average profit? So there is the formula for calculation of average profit. Total profits of last few years divided by number of years, and you will get average profit. So you can go to observe that by applying this formula or principle, we are going to calculate average profits. Then whatever the average profit we get, that can be multiplied by the number of years purchased. Then we will get goodwill of the firm. See the formula for the calculation of average profit. Under first step, how we are going to calculate average profits? Average profits formula. Yes, average profit formula is total profits of a given number of years divided by number of years. For example, in the problem, you are given 3 years profit. Last 3 years profit. So then you are asked to calculate average profit. So what we have to do, you can go to apply this formula. What is the formula? Total profits of given number of years divided by number of years. So how many years profits we are given? 3 years profit. Say first year, second year, third year. First year 10,000, second year 20,000, third year 30,000. So total of the profits become 60,000. That can be divided by number of years, that is 3. 60,000 divided by 2, 3, we can get 20,000. This 20,000 rupees is called as average profit. And next step, after finding the average profit, we can go to find the goodwill by applying a principle or formula. Average profit into given number of years means here, average profit into number of years purchased, given number of years purchased in the problem. For example, 2 years purchase of average profits become the value of goodwill of the firm. So then average profits must be multiplied with the number of years purchased. So in this, just before I given one example, what was the average profit? Rupees 20,000. Here 2 years purchase of average profits become the goodwill of the firm. So what we have to do here? 20,000 rupees into 2 years, then we will get 40,000. So this 40,000 becomes the goodwill of the firm. So for the valuation of goodwill under average profits method, we can go to apply two formulas. One is for the calculation of average profits, another is for the calculation of goodwill. These two formulas, if we apply, we can get the goodwill of the firm. So to students, I hope you are following me. See, if I explain firstly, you may or may not follow me. So what you have to do, each slide you can go to listen carefully, try to understand every point and take down important points, and pause the video, take down the content which appears on the screen, then practice that. Slowly you try to read it and understand it and apply it. See here, one problem is given, a simple problem, and we are asked to calculate goodwill under average profits method. The net profits of a firm for last 4 years were rupees 50,000, rupees 48,000, rupees 60,000, and rupees 62,000. So 4 years from profits are given in this problem. First year 50,000, second year 48,000, third year 60,000, and fourth year 62,000 respectively. So these are the profits of last 4 years. Next continuation. The goodwill is to be taken as 2 years' purchase of average profits of last 4 years. So 2 years' purchase of average profits will be the goodwill of the partnership firm. So calculate the value of goodwill under average profits method. So very simple. First, you read the problem twice in your mind and ask two questions yourself. One is that how many years profits are given in the problem? That is the first question you have to ask yourself. In this problem, we have been given 4 years profits. Okay, that is one. And that is that information is enough to calculate average profits. And second is that the goodwill is be taken as 2 years purchase of average profit. How many years average profits are purchasing for the calculation of goodwill? Here in this problem, 2 years average profits purchased to value the goodwill of the firm. So these two questions ask yourself in your mind, answer to those questions. Next, how we are going to solve this problem, you can go to see. Valuation of goodwill under average profits method. Step 1, calculate the average profit of 4 years' profits. Average profit is equal to total profit of number of years given in the problem divided by number of years. So here in this problem, 4 years profits are given, that is 50,000, 48,000, 60,000, 62,000. So divided by 4 years, and you will get 2 lakhs. That can be divided by 4. The total profits become 2 lakhs rupees, and that can be divided by number of years 4. then we will get 50,000. The average profits of the firm is rupees 50,000. Step 2, how we are going to calculate goodwill? Goodwill is called average profit into number of years purchased. So in this problem, you are given average profit amount is we calculated average profit amount is rupees 50,000, and in the problem that is given 2 years purchase of average profits of a firm will be valued goodwill of the firm. So here we can go to number of years purchased average profits into number of years purchase of average profits. So here 50,000 into 2 years, so two number two we can go to say. So and here you are getting 1 lakh rupee. This rupees 1 lakh becomes the goodwill of the partnership firm. Goodwill of the firm is valued for rupees 1 lakh under the average profits method. Like this we can go to evaluate the goodwill of the firm. In the annual examination you will be given a problem for 2 marks sometimes to evaluate the goodwill under average profits method. Then you can go to use this formula 1 and formula 2 and you will get the goodwill amount. So like this we can go to evaluate the goodwill of the firm. This is the example problem for the practice point of view I given you. Take down this problem and apply those two formulas and find out the goodwill of the firm. Okay, children. I hope you have understood what does it mean, goodwill? What is the definition of goodwill? What are the features of goodwill? The method of valuation of goodwill, that is average profit method, and circumstances under which goodwill is evaluated. Okay, all these points we have learned in this video. Thank you, children, watching this video.